Life as a respiratory therapist can definitely be difficult and challenging at times. It takes a special type of person to work in the medical field and treat patients who are sick. Therefore, respiratory therapists must have a particular set of skills in order to succeed, which is the topic of this video. Keep watching because I'm going to share the most important skills that RTs need in order to be successful. So if you're ready, let's get into it. A respiratory therapist is a healthcare professional who specializes in the diagnosis and treatment of respiratory disorders. Therefore, they essentially care for patients with conditions of the heart and lungs. Respiratory therapists work with patients of all ages, from newborns to the elderly population. They typically work in hospitals, but may also work in clinics, home care settings, and other healthcare facilities. As previously mentioned, the field of respiratory therapy is not for the faint of heart. To be successful as a respiratory therapist, it requires certain skills and a specific personality type. The first requirement is physical endurance. Respiratory therapists are required to work 12-hour shifts. If you weren't aware, that is a very long time to be on your feet and moving around. This is why it's important to have physical endurance when working in this profession. You must be able to withstand long hours and still have the energy to treat your patients properly. Next up is physical strength. Not only do you need to have endurance, but you also must be physically strong to a certain degree. Respiratory therapists are constantly lifting and moving patients. They also have to move equipment around, which can be quite heavy. Now, I'm not saying that you need to become a bodybuilder to be a respiratory therapist, but having at least some physical strength is often required to work in this field. Next up on our list is gross motor ability. Gross motor skills refer to the ability to use your large muscles to move your body. This is important because respiratory therapists are constantly on the move. They must move within confined spaces and maintain their balance while sitting or standing. The job also requires the ability to reach above your shoulders and below your waist. Therefore, you will need this everyday skill to get from one place to another in the hospital while completing general tasks on the job. And that leads to the next skill, which is fine motor ability. Fine motor ability focuses more on the activities that you must complete with your hands. This is an important skill for respiratory therapists because they are required to complete delicate tasks, such as 1, auscultation, 2, inserting an endotracheal tube, 3, sticking an ABG, 4, suctioning a patient's airway, and 5, cleaning a patient's tracheostomy, just to name a few. RTs must also be able to measure and record a patient's vital signs, such as heart rate and oxygen saturation. Next up on our list is mobility. Respiratory therapists are required to be very mobile in order to move quickly throughout the hospital during emergency situations. Have you ever heard of the term code blue? This is when a patient's heart stops and they need to be resuscitated. In these situations, a code blue announcement is made throughout the hospital. The rapid response team, including respiratory therapists, must be able to respond quickly in order to help save the life of the patient, which means that this profession also requires good hearing. Hearing. Respiratory therapists must have excellent hearing because they are required to listen to a patient's lung sounds with a stethoscope. This device amplifies a patient's breath sounds and provides helpful information about their condition. RTs must also be able to hear ventilator alarms, pagers, and important announcements, such as a code blue, as I just mentioned. And of course, respiratory therapists must also have good vision. Vision. That is because they need to be able to see a patient in order to perform an assessment and provide the necessary treatment. Good vision allows respiratory therapists to notice symptoms such as hypoxemia, which requires immediate intervention. Respiratory therapists also need good tactile skills, which refers to the sense of touch. This is important because RTs are required to perform skills such as 1, checking a patient's pulse, 2, chest palpitation, 3, assessing respiratory rate, And number four, assessing body temperature. This skill allows respiratory therapists to learn a lot about a patient's condition using their ability to touch. Next up is smell. The sense of smell is another factor that you might not think would be important for respiratory therapists, but it actually is. By working in a hospital, you're going to experience a fair share of foul smells. This can unfortunately be a turnoff for some people. However, the ability to smell unusual odors can actually tell you a lot about a patient's condition. This is why this is an important skill for medical professionals. Next up on our list is reading. Reading is an important skill for medical professionals because they must be able to interpret and understand a patient's medical record. This document includes important information such as the patient's, number one, medical history, number two, current medications, number three, allergies, and number four, procedures that have been performed. Reading comprehension is also important when it comes to being able to interpret the doctor's order. Otherwise, how would you know how to treat the patient? This next skill on our list is surprising to most people, and it is arithmetic. You're probably wondering, why do respiratory therapists need to know how to do math? Well, it turns out that arithmetic is actually a very important skill for this profession. Some examples include: number one, calculating medication dosages. Number two, calibrating equipment. And number three, counting the patient's pulse and respiratory rates. This skill is also required to perform certain calculations, including minute ventilation, temperature conversion, and calculating a patient's ideal body weight. Now, there's no need to panic. You do not need to be a mathematician to become a respiratory therapist. However, some basic arithmetic skills are required. Switching gears just a bit, next up on our list is emotional stability. Emotional stability is probably one of the most important skills for respiratory therapists because they need to be able to handle a variety of emotions. They will work with patients who are, number one, angry, number two, anxious, number three, depressed, and number four, in pain. It's important for RTs to remain calm in order to provide the best possible care for their patients. This is also helpful when dealing with difficult patients as well. The next required skill is analytical thinking. Analytical thinking is important for respiratory therapists because they must be able to solve problems quickly. For example, you might need to troubleshoot equipment that isn't working properly or come up with a plan to treat a patient who isn't responding to treatment. It's also helpful to evaluate outcomes and transfer knowledge from one situation to another, all while using long and short-term memory. Problems will also arise while on the job. Therefore, respiratory therapists must be able to break down the problem and come up with a solution in a timely manner. Which leads to the next skill on our list, which is critical thinking. Critical thinking is another important skill for respiratory therapists because it allows them to make sound decisions. This might include making a decision about whether or not to intubate a patient or when to start chest compressions. Respiratory therapists must be able to think quickly and make decisions that could mean the difference between life and death. Interpersonal skills are also important for respiratory therapists because they must be able to connect with patients and their family members. This includes being able to, number one, explain procedures, number two, give instructions, and number three, provide support. It's also important to build trust and establish rapport with your patients. After all, they are entrusting you with their lives. And one of the absolute most important skills for being a respiratory therapist is communication. This is an essential skill because RTs must be able to communicate effectively with patients, their family members, and other members of the healthcare team. Respiratory therapists must be able to speak clearly and distinctly in order to provide instructions and explain procedures. They must also be good listeners, because listening is one of the most important aspects of communication. Therefore, respiratory therapists must be able to listen carefully to their patients in order to accurately assess their condition. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching, have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.